Are you ready to take your financial analysis to the next level and impress your manager? In this video, I will show you 10 mind-blowing things you probably didn't know Python can do for financial planning and analysis and finance in general. And no, you do not need to know how to code. Stay until the end of this video and I will show you how you can use artificial intelligence to generate all of the code that I am showing. But on top of that, I will give you already this code. So if you just want to copy and paste what I did, you can also do it and just overlay your dataset. So let's start. So let's go to the first one. There are dashboards beyond capabilities of Excel. First, Python can create stunning interactive dashboards that go beyond Excel capabilities. So imagine that you can showcase a variance analysis, but with this degree of interactivity. You can also add different graphs like budget versus actuals, or even showcasing different trends and stock market analysis. If you ever want to do a risk and sensitivity analysis, these tornado charts are really good for it. And now with Python, you can create them in seconds. And even if you want to do something a little bit fancier for stock market analysis and technical indicators, again, Python should be your go-to. Now, the second thing is Sankey Diagrams. Now, this diagram basically showcases what are the different elements of an income statement, for example, so like revenue, operating expenses, cost of sales, and so on. And you can customize each one of these elements and colors with Python. The third one, it's cluster analysis. So imagine that you need to analyze revenue versus marketing expense, or even profit size by geo. With Python, you get all of these wonderful charts in order to do data visualizations. Now, on top of it, Python can also get data straight away from the different stock markets. Using the YFinance library, you can import data, let's say from Apple, Microsoft, Google, Tesla, and Amazon, and generate graphs in seconds. You can also do machine learning forecasting. So imagine that you need to build an accurate forecast that adapts trends, seasonality, and anomalies. With Python and Facebook's profit library, you can build this forecast. Now, if you also want to do a little bit more of machine learning, well, scikit-learn is your go-to library in Python. And with it, you can build advanced machine learning models in order to predict sales, classify customers, or even detect anomalies. It's very powerful and very easy to get started. Seven, we have Monte Carlo simulations. So imagine that you want to model 10,000 potential futures of revenue or of costs. Well, with Python, now it's possible. And this can give you a clear understanding of risk and uncertainty. You can also generate QR codes. So you only need to install this library and then run the following code. And you don't need to get a different application to get QR codes for you. With this, it will already be saved directly in your environment and you can generate it in seconds. Try this QR code. You will be surprised on what you find there. That is the efficient frontier for stock markets. So you can calculate and visualize this efficient frontier for portfolios. Python can allow you to optimize your investments just with a few lines of code. So definitely check this one out. And finally, one of my favorite ones is this pairwise relationships of financial metrics. So if you're ever wondering to know how to show and how to analyze how different financial drivers are correlated, well, with this graph, Python allows you to visualize these correlations and you can customize every part of the code. Now with Python, you can also explore salary distribution across departments or revenue distributions across departments and regions as well. Now, I will be sharing with you the code for all of this that you have seen on this video, and you will have it on the links below. So if you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe, and I will be sharing with you more things I'm almost sure you didn't know that Python can do for finance. Thank you. Are you still here? Perfect. So now I will show you how to use artificial intelligence to generate some of the code that I showed you. And you can replicate that for everything. But as I mentioned, I will also share with you all of the code so you can just overlay your data. Now, let's imagine that you want to forecast these different drivers. And you have date, and then revenue, expenses, profits, marketing spend, and headcount. Now, if you want to generate code with artificial intelligence, you just need to go to the LLM of your choice, so let's say ChatGPT, and tell it to generate Python code to create a forecast using profit library. And this is very important, you need to tell it how your data looks like. Now, in this case, I'm copying the column names and a few lines of the data. Now, one important thing is that this data does not need to be your real data set. So you do not need to show your data to OpenAI. You only need to show how the data looks like. So if it's dates, if it's numbers, and so on. And if you click on send this message to ChatGPT, then it will start generating this Python code for you. Now, in here, then you can copy this Python code into another environment, such as Google Colab or even Python in Excel. And if you want to use Python in Excel, I will leave a video below on how to do it. But then you can copy this code into an environment and run it there in order to use it. If you have questions on how exactly to do this, let me know in the comments and I can explain further in another video. Thanks for watching.